Now, let's face it, we all want to get a bargain, even if probably we had $38 million. And it shows when we shop at the supermarket, because now the good old store label stuff is growing at more than double the rate of fancy pants branded goods.
And it's not just a couple of staple items anymore. There are thousands of products to choose from now. But how do they compare, and can you really taste the difference? Mary Jane Aggett finds out.
It's a jungle out there. So many aisles, so many items, so many brands.
It's like 12 different types of jam.
And while price is a huge factor, so too is taste. Seven Sharp bought four everyday items: crackers, chips, lollies and biscuits.
We better have a chippy.
What? It's every day in our house. One a fancy label, one a store brand. We wanted to see if you really can taste the difference. Yes, you're saving money, but are you scrimping on flavour? We wanted some discerning palates to judge for themselves.
I've bought morning tea.
A Plunkett playgroup. First up, the chips. A store brand at $1.49 versus a manufacturer label at $2.19. That's 70 cents difference.
I think they're interchangeable to me. So I think this one is the more expensive one because it tastes more like potato.
You're actually wrong. So it just goes to show you're not actually missing out on taste in this instance, are you?
Next up, the crackers. The cheapies were $1.29. The branded product, $2.19.
Nice and crunchy.
That one, why do you like that one better?
It has salt in it.
Bit more salty?
Lots of crisp.
These kids have expensive taste. They're right, their cracker is the branded product. How about the mint slice? There's a dollar in it. Store brand at $1.99, the real McCoy at $2.99. Annie's the woman for the job. She knows her way around a mint slice.
They look similar, but the mint on this first one is more budget tasting than this one. So this one is budget and this one's mint slice.
Oh, you're good.
I know my mint slice.
And the lollies, $1.70 versus $2.79.
Which would you think is more expensive?
This one, because it's more crunchy.
Someone who knows about store brands is Pam.
Hi, Pam. I'm sorry, I have to call you Pam.
Pam's been busy. She's got around 3,500 products.
People aren't ashamed, are they, of buying the in-store brands?
No, not at all. So we're growing at double the rate of manufacturer brand at the moment.
It used to be just a couple of items. Now store brands do sanitary products, dog food, even duck.
For us, it was all about making the premium attainable. That's grown duck in our stores by 5 times.
Is it the same product, but just in a different packet?
Sometimes it can be, sometimes it can be a little bit different. It depends on the category.
And what about taste? Well, we tested individual items, but what happens if I make a whole recipe from the store brand products and the exact same recipe with the manufacturer labels?
Did you use the same recipe?
Yeah, so it's the same recipe. See if you can taste the difference.
This one, I'd prefer the flavour of the rough top.
Stripey one?
Mm. How are you getting there? I'm just getting chocolate.
Put your hands up if you think the stripey icing is the fancy brands. They're all wrong.
Are you going to?
Just goes to show, price isn't everything. And if you can save a couple of bucks, that's even more chalky biscuits for the kitty.
Oh, Millie.
I just think people were happy in the Seven Sharp office to get some beautiful home baking.
We were, Jane. To be fair, we were. And she's a good baker.
Oh, she can bake. So can Hilary as well. Just some fun home brand facts. Pam's olive oil, and I don't know if you knew this, Pam's olive oil is the highest selling olive oil.
I've used Pam's olive oil and I think it's very good and I can't tell the difference.
Yeah, obviously that's in the foodstuff stores. And the top four Pam's sellers, milk obviously, you know, your flour, your staples, salad bags, so bags of greens, and potatoes.
I didn't even know Pam's did potatoes.
Mm, they do potatoes.
Wow.
Yeah, and from Countdown, they've been quite busy in the old food lab, hot cross bun ice cream and cheeseburger spring rolls, which sound disgusting, but apparently are doing very, very well.
Yeah, those cheeseburger spring rolls apparently are fantastic. I haven't tried them yet. Now, the interesting thing is Jeremy and I did that taste test as well, and I could tell the difference. I've traced it a fair few slices in my time. And I did know straight away what was the premium brand. I think chocolate, you've got to be really careful because I think expensive chocolate is nicer.
You've got
but you couldn't tell.
You've got a very sophisticated Taranaki palate.
Well, I think so, maybe. Mm. But there are certain items I think you absolutely get away with. But when it comes to things like chocolate, I don't know if you should scrimp. Mm.